Halloween special sexy vampire makeup, and the reason I cannot talk properly is obviously because of these extra fittings in my mouth. These fangs are so not comfortable. I wonder how the vampires do it. Now this is a very spontaneous look. It's not something that I've tried before. I just took out my makeup palettes and decided to go crazy. I in fact bought some face paint from the costume store but didn't end up using any, and instead I put together this look just by using regular eyeshadows and colors that I have in my makeup kit. So if you'd like to find out how I achieved this sexy vampire look, then please keep watching. I'm going to start off by taking the lightest color from my Makeup Forever Camouflage Cream Palette. Apply some all over your top lids. Then I'm going to take the third color from this palette and apply it all over my bottom lids. Then I'm going to take this purple color from my NYX Purple Smoky Collection. I'm going to apply some of that color all over the crease and bottom lid. Then I'm going to take this shimmery maroon color from my Coastal Scents Winterberry Palette and apply that color all over my top lids. Then I'm going to take this dark black crayon from Maybelline Colossal Kajal and line my top lid and create the outline for my eyeliner. I'm going to apply that my bottom lid as well. And I'm going to use a black eyeliner, and I'm using my favorite Lakme Insta Liner. Now this is just a rough eyeliner. I'm going to smudge it out a little more. For now I'm going to take this white color from my Purple Smoky palette. I'm going to apply some of my brow bone as well. Then I'm going to take this shimmery black color and just smudge out that eyeliner. Then I'm going to line my lower lash line with the black eyeliner and create a shape like this. Then I'm going to extend the tear duct liner a little. Then I'm going to go back and take more of that purple color. Then I'm going to apply it my bottom lid, just in the outer corners. Then I'm going to top it up with that same shimmery black color. And I'm going to wing my lower lid as well. Then I'm going to blur out this rough edge and connect it to the corners of my nose. Then just reapply your brow highlighter in case it got lost while blending. Then I'm going to apply a white eye pencil just between my top and bottom wing. Then I'm going to apply my Sephora Outrageous Volume Mascara. Then I'm going to apply these sparkly red eyelashes that I bought from the costume store. Then I'm going to apply these bottom lashes. And that completes the eye makeup. Before moving on to the face makeup, I'm going to clean off any kind of makeup fallout. And I'm just going to use a cotton pad, a cleansing milk, and just clean off any excess fallout. Then I'm going to take the lightest shade from my Makeup Forever Concealer Palette and apply it my T-zone, the center of my nose, my Cupid's bow, and the bottom of my chin, and a little bit below the eye. Then I'm going to blend it out with a makeup blender. Vampires have very pale skin, and that's the reason why I've used such a light color. And I'm going to apply a darker color to the rest of my face, and I'm using my MAC Studio Fix in NC42, which is a bit darker than my skin tone. Mildly dust it over the areas where we applied that light color and just blend it all out. Then I'm going to use this really light shade from my L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Powder In fact, I'm going to apply it with my makeup sponge to give it a very thick coverage. For contouring my face, I'm going to use this really dark brown powder from my Coastal Scents blush palette. I'm going to go really strong on the cheeks. Go up to the temples. Pull it down slightly to make your face look nice and skinny. The principles of contouring remain the same whether you're doing regular beauty makeup or a costume makeup. Apply some on the jawline and the nose. I'm going to take some of this highlighter and apply it in the center of my nose and a little bit right below the black eyeliner. For blush, I'm using my Red Vino Baked Powder Blush from Milani. I'm going to go really strong with my cheeks. Then use a fat buffer brush and blend it all out slightly. Not completely, but just a little bit. I'm going to make my eyebrows slightly strong. I normally use brown eyebrow pencil, but for this one I'm going to use a black. Dust off any excess makeup you might have. Then I'm going to shape my widow's peak with a black pencil. And I'm going to create a heart shape. The final step is the lipstick, which is a very crucial part of the vampire makeup. So I'm going to line my lips with Mahogany from MAC. You want nice, big, full lips. Then I'm going to use this dark cocoa color called Good to Be Bad from MAC's Cream Sheen collection. Now to make this look a bit more scary, I'm going to draw some fake veins. I'm going to take some of that red color. Just going to make this look a bit messy. Now, of course, no vampire is complete without the fangs. So this is the final look, a sexy vampire Halloween makeup. Halloween is just days away and hopefully I finish editing this video by then. Fingers crossed. Gosh, I have makeup all over me. If you've enjoyed this tutorial, then please subscribe to my channel and do follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and I am a bit more active on Instagram right now. So please follow me on my social network if you enjoy my videos, and have a great Halloween, and until next time, it's